talk. We can see that we have a lambda overlay generated, and we have something to work with now. Let's check out our dyno screen to see what it made here on the very first pull. We can see it actually did 211 horsepower and 170 torque. That's actually really good. So let's jump in here. We can see that on the bottom end of the table here, we need to add some more fuel. So you can see right here, Control J, it's at 8%. Control J at 7%. Let's add 11 right here. Let's add 7 right here. Let's add 2 here. So I'm just following along with what the lambda overlay is showing me. I'm going to add 1 right here. Looks like it's telling me to take away here. I'll just take away 2%. And then up top here, it's telling me to add 2%. So let's take a look at our actual graphical plot of our data that we just captured. Let's jump in here. Let's take a look at some of the most important things that we can look at here. So fuel tuning, let's take a look here. We're at 41% duty cycle, so that seems okay. Air fuel was showing 13.1. Now we're lean, if we're depending on where we're at in the table here. Remember our target lambda is 0.86. And we can see as we're looking through here, it's showing us gasoline air fuel scale. If we actually jump into options, into sensors, let's take a look at our air fuel. If we want to look at it in our wideband lambda, we're going to go move it to units of lambda here. Now, if we give it a second, it should convert that all throughout the software. We can see air fuel here of 0.88. Our lambda target was 0.86. So now we're going to be looking here up top here as well in units of lambda. That's what we want to be looking at and referencing in the rest of the video. So if you're trying to switch it over to lambda, not only do you have to jump into options, settings, move into units here, change it to lambda unit there, but you also have to go into options, sensors, move into your O2 sensor, okay, here, your air fuel sensor, and then also select it here. So it does that conversion. Let me pop my headphones off real quick here. So we can see it's kind of squashed all the way down here. Our unit scale needs to be changed. Let's like jump to options. Jump back into sensors. Let's jump back in here again, I apologize, to our air fuel lambda. We can see our scale here is 10 to 20. This actually changes to 0.5 and then change it to 1.2. That's gonna be the scale for the lambda sensor. If we close this, give it a second, and let it replot it. Now we can see that we're gonna plot in that window here. Our spacing is gonna be much better here for units of lambda. So now we can see we're showing units of lambda, and that should be all good. So we've made our changes in our